Hey guys, Tofsky here, and welcome back to The Legend of Zelda Twilight Princess. Now, it's been a little while, sorry about that. I guess, if you haven't seen, or you didn't pay attention to the channel update, I ended up cutting my thumb pretty badly, trying to make chili. I'm not really a great cook, so things happened. In any case, my thumb is still not healed, or not healed as much as I'd like, I should say. So, I am kind of playing this, but I don't know how long it will go, or I don't know how long things will, or how things will work out. Like, this is not the most pleasant thing to do right now, and it's a lot harder. I'm kind of, like, holding the gamepad kind of awkwardly, so I don't have to use my thumb. So, this is kind of more an experiment than anything. But we'll see how well I can do this. Just because of that, though, I'm not going to promise that I'm going to be getting episodes out daily. I might only get one or two out this week, actually, because it's just a lot harder to try to play. And here we are, anyway. Hyrule Field. So, this will, kind of looks really odd in the distance, and like you can see where the twilight is, but then like you can see where it meets the rest of the area, so it's kind of cool. I love that effect. Anyway, let's just roll our way over towards where we're supposed to be, which is apparently to the right. And we should be good. Why do I feel like we went to the left first? I don't know, it's been so many years since I originally played this game. Go no further! There is a black wall ahead that blocks the way. I thought I would deliver a few letters, but it seems impossible. I am the honorable and dependable letter carrier, known to some as the Postman. Now that I have introduced myself, please, take this letter and read it for your at your leisure. To read a letter, press down on the D-pad to open the collection screen, yada yada yada. You can do that to read any letters you receive. Do it whenever you see fit. Well, my business is concluded. Onward to mail. I don't know why he wears short shorts. Do not ask me. So we should have the letters right here, and we can read them. The post office. If I have a letter for you, I will approach you at high speed. Please do not flee. I will flee, dammit. Given the option, I will flee. Okay, so. Yeah. Okay, so we should be able to kind of enter the twilight here. We are approaching it, so you'll see what it looks like right as we get to it. Kind of just dark void. And here comes Midna.
If I was if I was much closer than I thought. It was much closer than I thought. You remember, right? You know what this is. If you set foot in there, you might be a wolf again. For quite some time. For at least as long as it takes for you to save the light of Elden. From the twilight, anyway. So, shall we try to go see the life spirit of Elden? Yeah.
I guess we got no choice. Oh, we do have a choice. We could nod. That won't progress us.
Want me to let you in the twilight?
Yeah, sure. I got nothing better to do. You'd think Midna would, like, just, you know, casually, like, grab my hand and bring me in. Not, like, my entire body and throw me in. And Wolf Link.
That's a good boy. Now you need to listen to what I say from now on. Ah, look, how lovely. The black clouds of twilight are so fetching today. I feel so much more at ease here. And you look so much better like this than in those dusty old clothes anyway. So, let's get going.
Okay, so, second time we're in the twilight. What's here? Weak little plant thing. And a wooden sword. So, I believe that we can sniff now, and this kind of is an introduction to something new that we'll see later on more often. But you can kind of get the scent of things and track them down while you're a wolf link. So, you learn the youth scent.
See, isn't being a wolf more convenient? Now, use X to hone your senses. You've begun to reawaken as a wolf, I think.
So if we press X now, we can kind of track down where they've been. And there's no point in really slowing down. Just follow the trail. Until you're in an area like this. Now, I gotta try to remember how to do this. I think it's hold A. Yep. And we're still good. And there goes a warp point for us, so that's gonna be good. But we're missing a bridge.
What's this? That's strange. The bridge is gone. I wonder if this is the work of those shadow creatures. Oh, what a pain. Ah well, let's look for it. You, get out your map. Yellow arrow marks where we are. You knew that, right? Whenever you destroy those creatures of darkness, a portal opens up. Looks like this on the map. You hear me? It's called a portal. You better remember that. And in those woods we came through. Yes. It's gotta be around here. I'll use my powers to take you to a portal. Pick one you want to go.
So, one thing you might not remember, I think I actually pointed it out though, is there was a bridge, basically, kind of against the wall. And it's, you basically have to bring Midna there so that we can pick up the bridge and put it where it needs to be, and you can actually see it right here.
See, I told you, we're here. You know, most people can't leave the twilight that easy. You better be grateful. It's your job to look for the bridge. Look hard.
Okay, found the bridge.
Wow, it's perfect, don't you think? What do you think? Should we take it?
Yeah, let's take it. My bridge now.
Good little obedient wolf.
And that goes back here. So, let's go get our bridge. Because that's how bridges work. And we're already on our way back, so, you know, a nice quick little diversion. And here we are. Midna, place the bridge back for me. Apparently you don't have to fasten it or anything. It's just going to sit there and magically fit. And be sturdy somehow. I guess it's kind of attached. But not really. Hi, Midna.
See? Just as I thought. So, isn't the power of twilight amazing? Call me if you need any power again. It should help you find what you're looking for, don't you think? Alright, let's keep going.
So now we still have the scent. So we can kind of just keep running and following it. And pretty much just ignore everything. Unless it's those stupid little guys that are from portals. And here we are. Oh, look at that. Enemies.
Huh? What are they doing here? This is a perfectly... This is a pretty elaborate gate. Or are they trying to... What are they trying to keep in? Or out? I'll bet it's worth our while to dig in.
Yeah. I'm in. Hi, enemies. So now we can just kind of follow the path. And it'll take us to where we need to go. This crummy little village. Kakariko Village. Sounds familiar, doesn't it? Just like every Zelda game having a Kakariko Village. And let's kind of try to lure this guy over. Actually, I don't think we have to kill them all at the same time. I think as long as we get the last ones. Come on. So it was B, not A, that I have to hold. My bad. And look what it is. To the hero who has transformed into the blue-eyed beast in the realm of the shadows in Twilight. This way. Okay, welcome. Hi, spirit. I am a spirit of light. Hero chosen by the gods. Look for my light. Gather the light stolen by the shadows into this. Yay! I got the light grapes. My light grapes. The insects of darkness. They are the form taken by the evil that attached itself to my scattered light. In this shadowy twilight, the shadow insects are invisible, much as the people from your light world are. With the last of my power, let me mark your map with the locations of the tears that have turned into shadow insects. But be careful, the darkness now hurts you. Yeah. Stop it! I don't care. So, let's go get these insects. I feel like the map is kind of like reversed of the actual map in the other game.
Hey, you can climb here.
And, yeah, let's break into this house. But what's inside the house is more important. Let's take a look. There we go, we found them. Cripes!
I don't see those black brutes anywhere. They've got to be hiding somewhere. Waiting for their helpless little prey to come out. Then they'll feast.
We are safe here. We are safe as long as we remain here, child. Be at ease.
Oh yeah. I wonder if those monsters out there will agree with you. They sure didn't seem impressed by my bombs. How long do you think we can hold out in this sanctuary? Against beasts that strong, huh? Once they attack, it's over. Remember that lady from the general store? Just one of those things attacked her. And a whole gang from town went to save her. And what happened? She was already gone. And there were two monsters waiting. You connecting the dots? That means if we get attacked by them, then we'll be... Burns!
He clearly is not very considerate.
Hides in a welder's mask. Look, Renato. All I mean to say is that it's risky here, too. Ain't there some place we can hide?
This is a cellar.
What? You've got a cellar? Where's the entrance, man?
The entrance to the cellar is designed to open when all of the candles have been lit.
I would not do that.
When Father instructed me to secure the cellar, I saw insects like the beasts outside. Beth, don't cry. It'll be okay. Link is coming to save us.
Ominous.
Link is coming. The Link is already here. They just can't see me.
I can feel it. Those kids knew you'd come save them. What a hero. How sad to be right in front of someone and not even noticed at all. You are chosen by the gods, and only that keeps you from turning into a spirit, or worse, into a dark monster when you enter Twilight. And no one knows what you have done. You may be doomed to toil in obscurity forever. You're the type to worry about everything, I can tell. But don't fret over Princess Zelda. She chose this state of affairs, after all. Anyway, what with having to light candles to get to the basement? Not very subtle, is it? So what are you going to do now, Mr. Lonely Little Hero?
Well, one thing we can do is we can grab this stick and we can technically light the candles. Come on. I will light the candles with my stick. So hard being a dog, wolf, whatever. I will light my candles. That's one, two, three, and no. Hopefully they don't all go out. Nope, they don't. Oh, I don't need the stick anymore. Let's go down to the cellar. Now we should be able to sense everything down here. That's one, two, and three. Give my tears of light. And I'm gonna loot these hearts, apparently. Okay. I think that's all, everything of value here. Let me out, Midna.
That's me. How about that? Looks like you can climb the scaffolding.
You mean you can? And then I can jump? There we go. The graveyard. And I don't see anything actually in here, on the map, or otherwise. I guess we can climb up here if we wanted to take a look, but I guess there's technically a bit of stuff that you can dig up here. Probably all hearts. Yep. But there's nothing really we can do here right now. So let's make our way back out and hit the graveyard. And try to collect the rest of the light, tears of light. Fill my grape of light. So you can see the rest of the spots on the map. So we should just be able to run up. And this place is kind of 3D. There's different things that you can climb, go up, go down, etc. So you just kind of have to be aware of that. Kind of makes finding these things a little more difficult. They're not too challenging to find, though. I think there's one in here for some reason. Although I could be wrong. I can light that on fire. And we can find a bug. And we can kill the bug. So we got combat music in here. And that's because there's enemies here. And okay, they're down. There's also a chest. We can grab that, probably. Can we grab that as Wolf Link? We can. Wolf Link headbutts chests. Good to know. Oops. And you go. Okay, so this should be pretty much cleared out. Let's go grab that. And there's nothing in there, okay. Is there anything in these ones? I guess we could probably check this as well. But I don't see anything of value here. Let's open these up, I guess, and then let's make our way back down. Lay down. That sound you keep hearing is actually that thing, those branches catching fire. Okay, yep, nothing here. So how do we get out of here? Maybe you can just climb up here. And then we should be able to get out. So let's see how many we have left. So there are none on this side, so we just have to go to the other side. Now, I think we might have to climb up here to get to the other side for some of them that are really far away. Not here. Anything of value here, actually? I didn't think so, okay. So, I mean, you can read what this is. I believe this is like a hot spring? Yeah, a Kakariko hot spring. Now, we need to get to the other side. Which, I mean, it's much like this side here. You have to climb somewhere, and I believe you kind of climb from here? And then you start at one place and you just keep making your way further. Just go back in there. And this is barred off, so we can't really go there. But we can kind of go down here. So let's go get the ones in here. Not seeing anything, but let's go ask Midna.
If you want to go outside, we'll have to climb up here. But don't you think you should take care of business first?
So there's something in here, probably. So, if you look around, you can actually push this, I believe. And reveals a bug thing. That's what I want to do. And I think that's all the ones in here. So let's go out of here. Okay, now we have a little bit of a problem. We kind of have to go over there somehow. And it kind of looks quite high up. So how do we get in? Well, I think you can go from this side as well. Yeah, and through this window. If I do that right. I think. That looks about right. Maybe I have to charge it, I don't remember. Haha! We are now in. Okay, so what's here? Hey, we can read signs. Flammable. Lanterns strictly prohibited. Interesting. Flammable, you say? Hey, lightning bug. So now that we've done that, let's go get out of here. So now we're on top. And we kind of want to get further up here. Make our way over to these other ones. Which look like they are in here. There we go. So come on. Let's see what's in here. Flammable, you say? Look at all those flammable signs. Huh? What did you do? Sorry, but as romantic as this is... That voice is hard on the throat, how? And I'm out of water, cool. Oh well, I'll keep trying. Sorry, but as romantic as this is, I'm not gonna stay here with you. I'm getting out. So we kind of want to, I think, take these guys out. But this place is kind of exploding, so I think we just exit. And I think they blow up maybe with it. So let's get out of here. And it exploded. And there's our tears of light. Nice effective way to kill them. Huh.
I don't suppose there's a nicer way to hunt these things, huh? Well, you had to sacrifice someone's health to find tears of light. But that's how the cookie crumbles, right?
Yeah, keep in mind. My tears of light. Now, we are missing three. And this is why this is kind of a little annoying. Because I don't recall where these last three are. They're probably in houses, though, since you don't see them on the map. But let's just scale up here and see what's up here. And there's another building up here that we have yet to be in. Can we get in? Looks like there's a little hole here, so... Maybe there's something in here. So... I suppose we can try climbing up. Anything of value? Come on. One up. I don't see anything in here. Okay. Doesn't matter. Yeah, I remember having a bit of difficulty trying to find these guys. When I did this on my first playthrough, I don't remember very much about it because that's, I guess, almost 11 years ago at this point. Oh, there's a treasure chest over there. Nice. But I mean, I suppose they could also be outside. I'm guessing they're likely in a house, though. This place is all rubble now. Okay. But I mean, we can go back in this house. This is where we found the one. And I remember blowing up a place, that's why. I was kind of curious if I did it here or not, I didn't remember where. It was just this storehouse. But yeah, I'm not seeing anything of interest. I may have seen something actually, as I exited there. Let's go back in. It looked like there was a barrel I could break, potentially, and get underneath. No. So that's like the storefront. This is actually a bomb shop. When you're able to buy bombs, I believe, after you beat the area. When you restore these things. Maybe not. Considering I just blew up the guy's bomb supply. I kind of feel like I'm supposed to go under one of these still. So, yeah. I'm going away. Nice try, enemy. So I don't think I've been in this one yet. Where my rupee? Where'd it go? Not seeing anything of interest yet. Rupee, you're mine. Annoyingly, it's not letting me. I won't try getting up there. I probably messed something up. I probably have to use the boxes that are there or something. Or stop being an idiot. No. Good try, enemy, but I am not fighting you. Okay. Round two. Nope. So is there anything we can do here? I don't think so. I want to go up there. There's fire here. But I can't light anything on fire in this place. So I guess we're stuck going back outside. No. Yeah, I'm kind of stumped. What on earth did I do originally? I don't remember. Yeah, it happens. So So I remember going inside some things. Back here. Rude. Now, was there an area here? No. There was not. I feel like I went between here at one point. And then I feel like you actually had to go, like, underneath, like, a little shop floor or something, but... I've already been in there. This is the inn, apparently. Have I been in there? I don't recall. Now, do I want to go back up? So, I guess this is where it gets a little confusing, is some areas have more than one place where you can go, because I think... No, go away. I didn't mean to talk to you. So, where is this taking me? So the graveyard might actually have something. I kind of just didn't pay attention, but... There are places like this where there are actually some at certain places like this. When you're outside or you go to a different area. Come on. It's starting to get hard to play. Thank you for the interest of time. I'm going to probably just... look it up, and then come back. I could try pushing these, I guess, first. And you. Yeah, for the interest of time, we'll be right back. I haven't actually gone this way yet, have I? Towards Death Mountain. I don't know if I have to. Kind of just thinking though that these three might be here. And considering I got a cutscene, I'm guessing they are here. Looks like the path's impassable. But I can get you up there if you want. Yeah. Let's go. Hey, look, a Goron.
Oh, why do I have to stand guard? The ladder is destroyed, so it is not like any humans will come up. And what is it with the Elders Rift? If we have a problem the humans can help with, we should ask. It's better than suffering for the sake of our pride.
So, I guess they have problems. And by the way, look, three things on the map. I guess that answers all our questions on the last 3 hours. Okay, let's just kill these things. And then, Midna, please give me the command. Or not. And it looks like a Howling Stone here. Okay, Howling Stone, let's hear. And now, how you're supposed to get that is you're supposed to listen to the pitch of the whistle. But I kind of recall some of these, vaguely. Hey, Wolf. I howled at you. You howl back. There, I played my song by howling. Yes, I howled. Let teachings of old pass to you. Take sword in hand and find me. So, we basically... Now we have basically unlocked the spirit that we can learn another sword art from. And he is there. And this is waiting for us. Ow. So we just have two more. Kind of just have to continue our way up the Death Mountain here. I like how they've added geysers in this version of Death Mountain. That just makes it more realistic. And, yeah. What a pleasant looking area, Death Mountain. You know, all dark and evil looking. And there's four of those guys. Let's go kill them. Okay, that's two. And you'll notice it's kind of a wacky shape as well. So you kind of have to lure them. In fact, I may have killed the wrong order because it might be very difficult to get these guys. Won't stop me from trying. But, yep, as you can see. So let's just try to take these guys out. And yeah, this is where it gets a little more challenging with these stupid guys. They're never really a threat, but... You just have to sometimes kill certain ones in certain orders. And there we go. Okay, now we just have to continue making our way. Actually, there should be... insect right over here. Chase you down, insect. And now we just have one more. Which I think we have to climb up here for, maybe? He's kinda up there, it looks like. I will climb. And I will continue to climb. That's apparently all I'm good at. And climbing. No! No gas. This is taking me back the other way. Okay. So we have to figure out where it is. It looks like it's kind of that way up there. Can I get up there? I guess Midna will have to let me jump, and usually you can't jump unless you're on like a ledge or something, so. There we go. Kinda have to wait for that geyser, otherwise you just get knocked off mid-jump. Why do I have to stand guard at a dead end at the bottom of a cliff like this? Wait a second. Have they tucked me out of the way because they think I'm useless? Maybe. Yeah, I don't want to work. So we just have to find the last of this here. And... some interesting rumbling. Almost like the volcano's erupting. Probably because it is. Come on, let me up. Ow. You stay out of my way. Now, the biggest problem with the, I don't know if the volcanoes in this one are like that, but like in Ocarina of Time, for example, the volcanoes would only... They'd just kind of be annoying, because it would just drop, it would just kind of drop the boulders on you every so often. This one is kind of more random. Okay, we're getting close. Hot! Another fumarole. And once again, in the worst possible place. I suppose this path is impassable now. No, I don't want to care. If I were to get knocked down that way, I'd get knocked back in an instant. I'm sure of it. If my legs were as strong as the elder's legs, I might be able to stomp my way through. You stay down. So, I'm trying to think, what's like the things actually down here, so... I don't think it matters that that's impassable. Just kill off these enemies. And now let's look, it is! Get your butt back here. And I got all my water. My grapes have been charged. So there we go. Not too bad. About a 15-minute recording. But after this, we're gonna call it. So, we have now restored light.
You were there.
Ah, I was just starting to have fun. Don't forget that fused shadow. Yeah, see you later.
Okay. So let's go see the spirit. Whose domain we have restored. And it is freaking huge. My name is Elton. I am one of the light spirits of Hyrule. I am the spirit that guards these lands. O great hero chosen by the gods. The dark power you seek lies in the sacred grounds of the proud mountain dwellers. But already, those grounds have been defiled, draped in shadows, and seeded by evil. You must go to those sacred grounds and cleanse them. What am I, your janitor? Come on. I'm kind of waiting for him to be like, oh great, janitor of Hyrule. You must clean up the darkness. Equip your mop and bucket. I don't know. Ah, this place is great. Oh look, it's the kids. Link! I have saved the day. Seabath, I told you Link would save us. Good old Link. You are the one from Ordon, whom these children spoke of? We are well met. I am Rinaldo, shaman of this town. And this? This is my daughter, Luda. Clearly, they don't like him. The beast took us and left us to die.
But Mr. Renato found us. At first, I couldn't believe they had come from so distant a place as the Ordana province.
It's not that far.
Yeah, we don't remember much. All of a sudden, everyone was captured, and then, until now, it's been like a nightmare. Yeah, it was like a terrible dream, and we couldn't wake up.
Nightmares are everywhere these days, it seems.
This village has certainly seen its share of recent hardships. The dark beasts attacked, but even worse was the sudden and implicit and inexplicable change in the mountain-dwelling Goron tribe. They had long been our friends, but suddenly treated us as foes. Even now, they refuse to permit us entry into their minds. It strains the limits of belief.
Wow, Toph, you're tired. Go to sleep.
To think that such a gentle, proud tribe could change so suddenly. It makes me wonder if something in those minds is the cause of this change.
In any case, you must take these children and flee the village before more nightmares descend.
I, of course, cannot leave my village in such a time. There is no telling what may happen to us. But it is my job to try to coax the Gorons back from their recent change of heart.
No. Me? I have to do that? No. I believe what I have to do is save. Anyway, guys, once again, sorry about the delay. Kind of didn't expect to injure myself. I'm going to be trying to record more of these. I don't know how many I can record right now. This kind of hurts. Hurts to use a thumbstick, so I think that I might try to get another one out this week, but I wouldn't expect really more than one or two more this week. If that, I might even skip the week depending on how many other ways I injure my thumb, so. Oh well, that's life, right? Anyway, until next time, take care.